Hello students, welcome to AC Engineering. And this video also we are going to see the one more example regarding an signal flow graph. The last video we have discussed the very preliminary level of an signal flow graph tutorial problem with one forward path. Now we can see with a two forward path model, go through the question. Here the question given us the signal flow graph for a feedback control system shown in figure, the following figure, and determine the closed loop transfer function CFS by RFS. So while they are giving a problem like this, the first step we need to observe the nodes. So node numbers starting from input to output means RFS to CFS. In that aspect we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 nodes. Then observe one forward path numbers. Forward path starting from input node to output node and it crosses the node only once. So in that aspect we have a two forward path starting from node 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and next forward path from node 1, 2, 3, then skip 4 and 5, 6. So here in this problem, first step k is equal to 2. Obviously, we have two forward path gains P1 and P2. Now draw the first forward path like this, first forward path like this, and write the forward path gain P1 equal to multiplication of all the gain values G1, G2, G3, G4 and G5. See here P1 equal to G1, G2, G3, G4 and 5. Then draw the second forward path. In the second forward path, we have an gains P2 equal to G1, G2, G6 and G5. First step completed. Then we'll go with the second step. In the second step, we need to find the individual loop gain. So students, while you are observing this problem, draw the question first and observe the individual loops, two non-touching loops and three non-touching loops by yourself. Try, then refer the video. So according to this, we have a number of individual loops. Loop means simply saying from output to input or either of an input node or either of an forward path nodes again. So accordingly here we have three individual loops, 1, 2, 3. Is it so? Fine. So individual loops 1, 2, 3. Then we have one more loop by considering an forward path 2. According to forward path 2, here we have one more loop. Means 3 to 5, again to 3, without including 4. So draw the individual loops one by one. So the individual loop gain, we have 3 individual loops in forward path 1 and 4th loop in forward path 2. So that our number becomes P11, forward path number, then individual loop number. Then P21 means individual loop number and forward path number. The second letter denotes forward path number. Forward path number. Then here P31. Then the second loop, third loop gains were written like this, third loop, and the fourth loop, it's in a fourth loop, second forward path, P42, P42 equal to G6, H2, H3, fine. So here it is P42 in a fourth loop in a second forward path. then observe the third one, two non-touching loop. Now find, is there any possibility of a two non-touching loops here? Yes, there should be a two non-touching loops. See here, loop number 1 and 3, 3 and 4, and 4 and 5, the next one 3 and 5. While observing all the things, here loop number 1 and loop number 3 doesn't have any common nodes. See here, it's connected 2, 3, it is connected in between 4 and 5. There should not be any connections in between 1 and 3, a third loop. So here the gain products of two non-touching loops available. Then write the two non-touching loops like this, gain products of an first combinations of two non-touching loops. Then calculate del. Del is equal to 1 minus individual loop gains summation of products of individual loop gains plus sum products of two non-touching loops. For that, substitute all the gain product values. Then find del k. Here del k equal to del 1 and del 2. So check, there is no part of the graph which is non-touching the forward path 1 and 2. So in that aspect, del 1 equal to del 2 equal to 1. And last step, transfer function t equal to 1 by del summation of k pk del k. So that here for this problem, the formula reduced as 1 by del p1 del 1 plus p2 del 2, because here k equal to 2. Then substitute all the values one by one accordingly, then you can find the transfer function. So transfer function, simply substitution of all the calculated values. Thank you students, thanks for your support. Keep on watching Easy Engineering for further videos for a better understanding. If you can like this video, kindly click on like button and note down your comments in a comment section for my reference. Thank you all.